this place that we've worked in now, the wonderful...
The seminar. Yes, it's the Seminar of Santiago in Braga, and it's a seminar for priests with between 40 to 50 priests that are studying there, become priests, and we went there to visit several different chapels and their organs, where my good friend John had the opportunity to test them, to try them, and to with different songs. And it was really magical and beautiful spaces and sounds.
The architect for all these rooms, could you tell me about
architects,
him?
We met one of the architects from Cerejeira Fontes, António Jorge, his name, and he was showing us the different chapels, so he was involved in designing one of the organs, and then full design of the last chapel we watched, which is the chapel Tree of Life. Actually, it's usually only open 1 hour per week for visitors, otherwise it's totally closed. But we had the opportunity through his showing us to go there today. And it's a chapel that is all designed out of wood and with no connections between the wood pieces of any sorts of nails or screws, but rather only mounted together and put together. And even the organ is made the same way.
Yeah, that was spectacular.
Massive wood.
In the first room, there was a Norwegian designer.
Yeah, in the first room, their collaborator from Norway, Asbjørn Andersen, he's from Bergen, from the School of Architecture of Bergen, BAS. He was fully responsible for that full room, where it was used wool for weaving the carpet and for curtains, all handmade in Portugal, and also the paper and color on the walls are also handmade partly from Norway, and then the paint is traditionally from tempura painting.
Yeah.
So it's a low budget, very simple, but you could feel the whole smell in the room.
Yeah.
Very familiar, very down to earth, very organic. Yes. Which would match very well the design of the organ and the sound and the acoustics.
Yeah.
Cerejeira Fontes, both the one, so Dojo and André, they are twin brothers and they were students of my father, and they got to know the Norwegian architect because the Norwegian architect was a guest teacher at Chalmers in Gothenburg when I was, for 15 years ago exactly, a student, as an exchange student. Then I got the opportunity to meet this sculptors from Norway.
Funny.
And then Asbjørn, I made the connection with my father, and then they have made lots of exchanges between Porto and Norway based on that for many years.
Yeah.
And now they do a lot of different masterpieces connected to their jobs here.
Yeah, wow, that's wonderful. Yeah. Exchange, good exchange. Yeah. Good exchange. So if you could say something final about what you like the most about the final room, the tree.
I think it was, I have been there before, and I think it was to perceive the sound of it. Today I got the opportunity to perceive it in the sound flowing and using the space, because I remember last time we were there was very late at night, and we had to be pretty quiet as the most priests were sleeping in the corridors beside us, and we were very silent using the space. And enjoying just the spaces and the light and so on. And this time we got to perceive the sound of the space as well. And I think that was magical. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for showing us.
Thank you for making it function for us.
You're welcome.